story is that proved for us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never, can protect you in this earthly life or protect you after death. So if you believe that whatever struck you will never miss you, so why not you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The first story is Allah will send you His soldiers even after you die to protect you. So this is the story of Asim ibn Sabir. It was a companion, and he killed two believers. Then the mother of the two believers, her name is Sulafa, she vowed for Allah to drink wine in the skull of Asim ibn Sabir. So she said, we have to kill Asim first, this believer, and then she sent people to cut off his head and ask them to bring his skull in order to drink wine in this skull. So Asim ibn Sabir died in one of these battlefields, and they managed to like follow him and make sure that they will cut off his head and bring it to Sulaifa, this lady. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prevented them to touch or approach his body even after his death. Look at the soldier of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it was a swarm of swifts, wal garas, that prevented them of touching Asim ibn Sabir. And then they said, okay, we'll wait until the night and then try again to cut off his head. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent a torrent that carried his body away from everybody, so nobody could touch him, subhanAllah. This is when you are like in the fetal state, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taking care of you. When you, after your death, still Allah can send you his soldier and protect you, subhanAllah. So no one, if the whole you, the whole community unite to cause you harm, they will never cause you harm without the will of Allah's compassion. So at that moment, if a hardship has struck you, then you have to understand that this is with the will of Allah. Because if you cannot accuse that person of causing you harm. سُبْحَانَهُ وَاجْتَمَعَ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنَّ عَلَى أَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعَ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنَّ عَلَى أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ. So you have to believe that this is very strong, like whatever struck you is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then there is another story of two men. It was the two brothers, and the two brothers inherited a big wealth. And then one of them was righteous believer, and the other one was an evil one. Then the evil one lost all his money because he was like losing his money gambling and drinking alcohol. And the other one was a good believer, he was used to give charity and this, so he became wealthier and wealthier. So unfortunately, the evil brother plotted like, he was inspired by evil, by Satan, to plot, let's say, the evil brother plotted for his eldest brother to lose all his fortune, and he was inspired by Satan to ask about a man that is very strong, having evil sight, you know, evil eye. So like he brought this man who was famous of having like very strong and powerful evil eye, and then he went on the way of the caravan of his brother, and the trading caravan, and told him, whenever you see this trading caravan, just focus your eye on it, your evil eye, and just to let him lose all his fortune. What happened? He plotted everything against his brother, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look how he protected him. So when they went on their way and found the caravan coming in, then the evil brother said, look at the caravan, it's coming from far away. And then the evil man, who is like famous for having evil eye, said, oh, how powerful your sight is. And at that moment, the evil brother lost, had pain, terrible pain in his head, and lost his eyesight. So again, this is a good lesson for us. Even if you thought everything and you make sure that to make it the perfect way, but Allah is protecting the caravan of the pious man, then nothing could ever harm him, cause him any harm. So this is like two stories making you sure that everything is by Allah's will. So we have to go to submission. And Imam Shahrawi said, At-Taslim A'la Martaba fi Iman. That means submission is the highest level of Iman or being a good believer. How Taslim is submission to Allah, because you know that everything is by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then for you is a good lesson to submit. How can we submit? I give you this lesson from Surah Hud. How Sayyidina Nuh, the Prophet Noah, it was very hard for him to submit. He's like human being saying, I'm a prophet. But just I want to ask you Allah, why is this happening? Or this is like, I just repeat the ayah, this one, Surah Hud, number 45, 46, and 47. ونادى نوح ربه فقال رب إن بني من أهلي وإن وعدك الحق وأنت أرحم الراحمين قال يا نوح إنه ليس من أهلك إنه عمل غير صالح إني أعظك أن تكون من الجاهلين قال رب إني أعوذ بك أن أسألك ما ليس لي به علم وإلا تغفر لي وترحمني أكون من الخاسرين. If we translate here very fast, Noah called upon Allah and said, O Allah, surely my son is one of my family. And you promised me, and your promise is true. And you are the judgest of the judge. So Allah replied, he's not of your family, for his conduct is unrighteous. So don't ask me whatever you don't have knowledge. I counsel you to be ignorant. So here we learn something very important. When Noah couldn't like take with them, he saw his son drawing and it was very hard for him. Then the prophet Noah asked Allah. He said, well, my son is one of my family. He was very polite. He didn't say, why is this happening? He just saying, it's just one of my family, my son. He didn't say, why is this happening? Just it's in a polite form, yeah? In a polite way, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, oh, it's very hard, but he didn't say it's very hard. Then Allah told him, don't ask, I give you advice to be ignorant. So can we ourselves play the role of ignorant people when a hardship struck us and we don't understand why is this going on? We have to be like acting as an ignorant. إِنِّي أَعِذُكَ أَن تَكُونَ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ. Don't ask and be ignorant. So Noah said, well, رَبِّ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ أَن أَسْأَلَكَ مَا لَيْسَ لِي بِهِ عِلْمٌ. This is what we should repeat whenever we are in a hardship or affliction. And we don't understand why this is happening for us. That means I seek refuge in you, Allah, not to ask you why this is happening to me. So please use this verse, because we are weak, and we might just ask even inside us why this is happening to me. So if without the Allah assistance, we will ask, why will this is happening to me? So I seek refuge in you, not to ask you why this is struck me or why this happened. So please, yeah, inshallah, we all of us, we need it badly. وَإِلَّا تَغْفِرْ لِي وَتَرْحَمْنِي أَكُنْ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And please, Allah, forgive me for what I've been saying. He didn't really say a big issue there when he said this is Noah is part of my family. But we might be in such a situation and we will ask Allah forgiveness for any question we've asked in the wrong way. So inshallah, this is a good lesson for all of us.